Today's winners and losers on Wall Street with our financial expert, Rob Black. And, you know, Rob, we see the economy improving, but people's salaries really haven't been.
Yeah, not bad this year. Average raise is going to be about 3%, which
is about inflation, right?
Inflation's about 2.1.
Okay, so it's like a 0.9% raise is what people are going to get, less than 1%.
You are correct, sir. Now, again, not everyone's getting that 3% raise. If you're considered a poor worker, you're getting about a 2.6% raise, which that's kind of where I'm at. And if you're a high performer, you're getting about a 4.5% raise. So 2.1% is inflation. You want to beat it. Average American getting a 2.9% average raise in 2014 over 2013. Median salary, the average salary of workers in America, $40,560. And again, the median, not the average. So that's worthy of note. That doesn't sound like very much.
Yeah, tough to keep up with inflation with that as well. Big news from Twitter. They're announcing this buy button inside of Twitter. What do you think about this? Winner or loser?
I'm a little overwhelmed.
Oh, you are?
Do I need one more payment service?
Yes,
I don't think
do.
I do. Now with Twitter, you know, I use it for news feeds, so I'm not going to be buying anything really, but some people will use it for sports scores, and you know, maybe you get a sports score from the, you know, 49ers, buy the next home game ticket at a 10% discount, 15% discount. It's going to be for selling limited edition items, time-sensitive items, t-shirts, concert event tickets, things like that that are tied towards the social networking that people are tied with Twitter, obviously, towards. I don't get it. It just seems like a little bit much. Apple's coming out with a new payment service tomorrow. That seems a little bit more real, where you're paying with things with your phone, but not through an app on your phone. I just don't get it.
Yeah, we're hearing all the rumors flying about what's going to come from Apple.
Yeah.
What I heard today was that the watch is going to have the NFR technology, and you're going to be able to pay with your watch?
NFC, near field communication.
Oh, near field, right.
Yeah, there's actually a leak of the photo of it on Reddit. So if you go to REDDIT, go to Apple, you can see what the watch looks like, and it looks good. It looks really, really cool and very, very sharp. You know, should you buy the stock today or tomorrow? The answer is no. History says otherwise, unless, of course, they come out with a watch. And unless, of course, the watch is all that and gorgeous and wonderful and it's not a leaked photo. Point being is that history, except for the 4S, buying it today doesn't really pay off for you. You actually underperform the S&P 500 over the next 30 days. So don't feel like tomorrow's big announcement, which they're doing in Cupertino, where they introduced the Macintosh building, at the same building where they introduced the Macintosh 30 years ago. So there's this, like, that's not, that irony's not being lost on people.
Should be interesting.
Big announcement tomorrow.
Yeah, we're really excited to see what's going to happen tomorrow. And quickly, the Olive Garden trying a new thing. We run Olive Garden commercials when you're here, your family. They're doing a VIP thing at the Olive Garden.
Yeah, so since we run commercials, I should be careful what I say.
Yes, let's be nice here to the Olive Garden.
Let's call this new thing Pasta Up the Kazoo. Because this is a gimmick to get us to go. You basically spend $100 today, starting at 3 p.m. Eastern Time. You jump on their website. You can get a pass. There's only 1,000 of them, where you can eat all the pasta you want for 49 days in a row. It seems pretty outlandish to me. For $100, you can eat lunch and dinner, as many pasta pasta, Coca-Cola, breadsticks, nothing, well, salad's healthy for you, but everything else doesn't seem all that healthy. So it seems like if you work right next to one, maybe that's a great idea. Maybe you'll bring some friends in with you and they'll actually have to pay and not eat off your unlimited pasta. But Pasta Up the Kazoo today at 3 o'clock Eastern Time. Jump on the website at 12 if you want one of those very VIP limited edition passes.
And they say when you're there, you're family.
And for the record, one last thing that I want to throw out. Fast food is, they're struggling. Yeah. Endless appetizers at TGIF's. Endless shrimp at Olive Garden, at Red Lobster. And Outback has $15.99 unlimited steak. And, well, the steak's not, steak's limited, but unlimited shrimp goes with it.
So many choices, so little time. And if you have a question for Rob, you can post it on his Facebook fan page. And we'll answer it right here on Cron 4. We'll be right back.